In this topic, you'll learn how you can use Cloud Dataflow to perform extract, transform, and load operations. Cloud Dataflow offers simplified streaming and batch data processing. It's a data processing service that's based on Apache Beam that lets you develop and execute a range of data processing patterns: extract, transform, and load, batch, and streaming. You use Cloud Dataflow to build data pipelines, monitor their execution, and transform and analyze that data. Importantly, the same pipelines, the same code that you're gonna write, works both for batch data and streaming data. You'll explore pipelines more in detail shortly. Cloud Dataflow fully automates operational tasks like resource management and performance optimization for your pipeline. All resources are provided on demand and automatically scale to meet requirements. Cloud Dataflow provides built-in support for fault-tolerant execution that is consistent and correct regardless of data size, cluster size, processing pattern, or even the complexity of your pipeline. Through its integration with the GCP console, Cloud Dataflow provides statistics such as pipeline throughput and lag, as well as the consolidated worker log and inspection, all in near real time. It also integrates with cloud storage, cloud PubSub, cloud data store, cloud Bigtable, and BigQuery for seamless data processing. It's the glue that can hold it all together. It can also be extended to interact with other sources and syncs like Apache Kafka and HDFS. Google provides quick start templates for Cloud Dataflow to allow you to rapidly deploy a number of useful data pipelines without requiring any Apache Beam programming experience. The templates also remove the need to develop the pipeline code, and therefore the need to consider the management of component dependencies in that pipeline code. You'll do a lab later where you'll create a streaming pipeline using one of these Google Cloud Dataflow templates. Let's look at pipelines now in more detail. A pipeline represents a complete process on one or more data sets. The data could be brought in from external data sources. It could then have a series of transformation operations, such as filters, joins, aggregations, etc., applied to that data to give it some meaning and to achieve its desired form. This data could then be written to a sink. The sink could be within GCP or external. The sink could be even the same as the data source. The pipeline itself is what's called a directed acyclic graph, or a DAG. P collections are specialized containers of nearly unlimited size that represent a set of data that's in the pipeline. These data sets could be bounded, also referred to as fixed size, such as the national census data, or unbounded, such as a Twitter feed or data from weather sensors coming in continuously. P collections are the input and the output of every single transform operation. Transforms are the data processing steps inside of your pipeline. Transforms take one or more of those P collections, perform an operation that you specify on each element in that collection, and produce one or more P collections as an output. A transform can perform nearly any kind of processing operation, including performing mathematical computations on data, converting data from one format to another, grouping data together, reading and writing data, filtering data to only the elements that you want, or combining data elements into single data values. Source and sync APIs provide functions to read data into and out of collections. The sources act as the roots of the pipeline, and the syncs are the endpoints of the pipeline. Cloud Dataflow has a set of built-in syncs and sources, but it's also possible to write sources and syncs for custom data sources too. Let's look at different pipeline examples to get a sense of the processing capabilities of Cloud Dataflow. In this multiple transform pipeline example, data read from BigQuery is filtered into two collections based on the initial character of the name. Note that the inputs in these examples could be from a different data source, and that this pipeline doesn't go so far as to reflect an output. In this merge pipeline example, we're taking the data that was filtered into two collections in our previous multiple transform pipeline example and merging those two data sets together. This leaves us with a single data set with names that start with A and B. In this multiple input pipeline example, we're doing joins from different data sources. The job of Cloud Dataflow is to ingest data from one or more sources, if necessary, in parallel, transform that data, and then load the data into one or more sinks. Google services can be used as both a source and a sink. In this simple but real example, the Cloud Dataflow pipeline reads data from a BigQuery table. The source processes it in various ways, and the transforms writes its output to Google Cloud Storage, which is our sink. Some of the transforms in this example are map operations, and some are reduce operations. You can build really expressive pipelines. Each step in the pipeline is elastically scaled, so there's no need to launch and manage your own cluster. Instead, the service provides all the resources on demand. It has automated and optimized work partitioning built in, which can dynamically rebalance lagging work. That reduces the need to worry about hotkeys, that is, situations where disproportionately large chunks of your input get mapped to the same cluster. We've discussed Cloud Dataproc and Cloud Dataflow as managed service solutions for processing your big data. This flowchart summarizes what differentiates one from the other. Both Cloud Dataproc and Cloud Dataflow can perform map reduce operations. The biggest difference between them is that Cloud Dataproc works similarly to how Hadoop would work in the physical infrastructure. You would still create a cluster of servers to perform your ETL jobs. In the case of Cloud Dataflow, the process is serverless. You provide the Java or Python code and leverage the Apache Beam SDK to perform ETL operations on batch and streaming data in a serverless fashion.